Hello students, I am Bhajan and welcome to my channel Biology. So today we are going to talk about the breathing mechanism. This is in continuation of the lecture from the respiratory system. So to have the details of the anatomy of the respiratory system, please check out my videos. And आज हम बात करेंगे प्लस वन का टॉपिक है दैट इज ब्रीदिंग एंड रेस्पिरेशन. उसका एक सब टॉपिक है दैट इज मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग. ओके जी, फॉलोइंग आर द सेम मोटो एनसीईआरटी एज बेस गाइड एंड जो हमारे प्रीवियस नीट एग्जाम्स हैं उनमें आए हुए जो पेपर्स और क्वेश्चंस हैं दे विल बी आर डायरेक्शनल गाइड. तो होप अगर आपको ये कंटेंट हेल्पफुल लग रहा है सो प्लीज डू लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब. So let's start with today, that is mechanism of breathing. Okay ji, so we have already done with the structure of lungs and ek yahan se main chota sa pichha recap kar rahi hu aapke liye. The lungs are situated in the thoracic chambers in anatomically airtight chamber. So jo lungs jo hain they are situated in air tight chamber. Okay, the thoracic chamber is formed dorsally by vertebral column. Jo thoracic chamber hai, thoracic chamber mein dorsal side its vertebral column, ventral side its sternum and from below it is diaphragm, that is a membrane dividing the thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity, and lateral it is ribs. So dorsally by the vertebral column, dorsally by the vertebral column, ventrally by the sternum, laterally by the ribs, and on the lower side present the dome shaped diaphragm. The anatomical setup of lungs in thorax is such that any change in the volume of thoracic cavity will be reflected in the lungs cavity. Such an arrangement is essential for the breathing. Means if you expand your thoracic cavity, आपका जो lung का अंदर का cavity है वो भी increase कर जाएगा. To explain this, I have already drawn this diagram. So let's have a look over here. This is your whistle pleura, this is your parietal pleura, and in between is the parietal, is the pleural fluid. तो ये आपके पास, this is the pleural fluid. This is pleural fluid which is in the pleural cavity. So here is the pleural cavity. Fine. Okay. So here is diaphragm and this is the ribs. Now if you see over here, I would like to explain certain pressures over here before I start with the whole mechanism. जो बाहर का pressure है, the outside pressure is here, that is atmospheric pressure. This is approximately, I'll write it as AP. So this is approximately 760 mm of Hg, mercury. And here is the intra pulmonary pressure which is approximately also 760 mm of mercury. So if we see outside pressure is 760, inside pressure is also 760, that means roughly we can say this is almost at zero pressure. So it's of course not zero, but if we compare, so that means this is a zero. सो जो लंग्स में इस टाइम पे वी विल लेट्स टेक इट इज एज जीरो प्रेशर. सो दिस इज बेसिकली नेट प्रेशर की बात हो रही है, 760 माइनस 760. ओके, सो दिस इज योर वन. जो आपका प्लूरल कैविटी है, द प्लूरल कैविटी में जो प्लूरल फ्लूइड प्रेशर है, दिस इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4 millimeter लेस दैन योर इंट्रा पल्मोनरी प्रेशर, दैट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 756 mm ऑफ मर्करी. सो दैट मीन्स दिस जो आपका इंट्रा प्लूरल प्रेशर, इंट्रा प्लूरल प्रेशर इज 756 millimeter ऑफ मर्करी, वेयर इज इंट्रा पल्मोनरी प्रेशर इज 760. सो दैट मीन्स ओवर हियर इफ आई टॉक देयर इज अ डिफरेंस ऑफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4 millimeter. सो मीन्स दिस इंट्रा पल्मोनरी प्रेशर इज 4 millimeter less than intrapulmonary pressure. So I'll take it as IPP. Okay, so intrapulmonary pressure. So intrapleural pressure or intrapulmonary pressure. Now ye ho gaya aapka 4 millimeter. So this was the question in the previous NEET exams, that intrapulmonary pressure or jo intrapleural pressure hai, there is a, always a difference, and it is always negative with respect to intrapulmonary pressure. Means kya hua, lung ke andar ka pressure chahe kam ho raha hai chahe zyada ho raha hai, jo aapka pleural cavity ke andar ka pressure hai wo andar ke pressure yani ki lungs ke andar ke pressure ke relatively it is always on negative side. So what it is going to do, how it is helpful, this is what is the advantage of it. What is advantage of it? Its advantage is it prevent the collapsing of the lungs. Lungs wall. So what happened? When lungs deflate or maybe inflate, the two pleural membranes, that is parietal pleura and visceral pleura, they are closely in contact with each other. So there are chances of getting friction and they may collapse. So first of all, pleural fluid provide the frictionless movement, and secondarily what it is doing, whether lung is inflating or deflating, means if there is any change of the pressure inside the lung, this pressure always remain negative with respect to your intrapulmonary pressures. So I hope I make this thing clear. So ye to ho gaya ji hamara pressure ka. अब जरा एनसीईआरटी से बात करते हैं. कहते हैं ब्रीदिंग इन्वॉल्व्स फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, दैट एटमॉस्फेरिक एयर इज ड्रॉन इन एंड CO2 रिच एल्वियोलर एयर इज रिलीज्ड आउट. तो मींस क्या हुआ, हमने हमारे पास ऑक्सीजन जो आई है, अगर हम ब्रीदिंग का प्रोसेस की बात करें तो ऑक्सीजन जो है वो आपके इनसाइड आती है, यानी फ्रॉम एटमोस्फेयर इट कम्स टू your lungs. Okay, and lungs say CO2 aapki bahar jaati hai. So this is basically your external breathing, or we call it as ventilation. Fine, but iske saath aur bhi bahut sare process hai, aise nahi hai ki seedha gayi aur seedha aa gayi, because our cells are using oxygen. To wo cell se kaise hai कि आपके पास ये एल्वियोलाई से ऑक्सीजन आपके ब्लड में आई. सो ये लंग की एल्वियोलाई है, ये आपकी ब्लड कैपिलरी है. ऑक्सीजन आपकी एल्वियोलाई से ब्लड कैपिलरी के अंदर आ रही है. सबसे पहले तो एटमॉस्फेयर से जो आई वो आपकी एक्सटर्नल ब्रीदिंग होगी. अब यहां से यहां जाना, दिस इज कॉल्ड डिफ्यूजन ऑफ गैसेस, यानी डिफ्यूजन ऑफ गैसेस, ये हो गया डिफ्यूजन. पहला डिफ्यूजन हुआ आपका एल्वियोलाई और ब्लड के बीच में अक्रॉस द एल्वियोलर मेम्ब्रेन. देन दिस ब्लड इज गोइंग टू टेक दिस थिंग टू द टिश्यू. दैट मीन्स दिस इज द ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ गैस. फाइन. सो दिस इज द ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ गैस फॉर द ब्लड. सो दिस इज ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ गैस ऑक्सीजन. ओके. अब क्या हुआ, डिफ्यूजन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बिटवीन ब्लड एंड टिश्यू. तो आपका जो यहां पे ऑक्सीजन इज गिवन ओवर हियर टू द टिश्यू एंड CO2 इज टेकन आउट बिकॉज आपके सेल्स ऑक्सीजन को यूज कर रहे हैं और कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं. सो दिस इज मेटाबॉलिक एक्सचेंज इज देयर. सो ये जो आपका ये वाला पार्ट है, दिस इज योर इंटरनल रेस्पिरेशन और वी कॉल इट एज सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन. देन दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज अगेन यू नो टेकन बाय ब्लड. तो ये फिर ट्रांसपोर्ट हो गया उसका. देन दिस इज दिस ब्लड इज टेकिंग इट बैक टू द लंग्स, आई मीन एल्वियोलाई. सो हियर इट इज टेकिंग बैक. दिस इज ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ CO2. नाउ CO2 इज गेटिंग बैक डिफ्यूज्ड इनटू एल्वियोलाई. सो दिस इज अगेन डिफ्यूजन ऑफ CO2 एंड फ्रॉम CO2 इट गोज टू योर एटमोस्फेयर. सो दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दिस इज योर एक्सटर्नल वेंटिलेशन. So these are the steps we are taking. Diffusion of oxygen and CO2 between blood and tissue, utilization of oxygen by the cell, that is catabolic process, and resultant release of CO2 back again to the blood and then to the alveoli. So now we are going to start with the mechanism of breathing. I have already told you ki kis tarah se ye arrangement hua pada hai. So when we talk about the breathing part, सो ब्रीदिंग पार्ट में हमारे पास मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ब्रीदिंग. सो टू स्टेजेस हैं, इंस्पिरेशन एंड एक्सपिरेशन. सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट ब्रीदिंग, ब्रीदिंग में दो स्टेजेस आ रही हैं. वन इज कॉल्ड इंस्पिरेशन एंड सेकंड इज कॉल्ड एक्सपिरेशन. ओके. सो बाय विच द एल्वियोलर एयर इज रिलीज्ड आउट. The movement of air into and out of lung is carried out by pressure gradient between the lungs and the atmosphere. That little pressure gradient I have already explained ki how it is going to be done and aage hum baat karenge. So what exactly happened? So do cheeze yaad rakhna, jo breathing hai kis wajah se ho rahi hai. Breathing is outcome, yeah, due to, I should say, breathing is due to the pressure gradients. So it is due to the pressure gradients between lungs and atmosphere. Or second jo exchange ho raha hai between blood and tissue, that is also due to pressure gradients. So due to breathing ki baat karein, due to pressure gradients. Fine. Kiske beech mein? Between lungs and atmosphere. Fine. So inspiration can occur if the pressure within lungs, that is intrapulmonary pressure, is less than the atmospheric pressure. So less. Okay. First of all, we need to know what are the various muscles and what are various structures which are helping in the breathing process. So sabse pehle yaad rakhiye, the muscles which are involved. Muscles involved. टू प्रिंसिपल मसल्स यहां पर बात करेंगे. टू प्रिंसिपल मसल्स आर, नंबर वन इज द फ्रेनिक मसल्स और वी कैन से द मसल्स ऑफ डायफ्राम. दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल इंस्पिरेटरी मसल. This is a principal inspiratory muscle and it accounts for 75% approximately of normal breathing. That's a जो हम नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग टाइडल वॉल्यूम की बात करते हैं. सो आई एक्सप्लेन दैट वॉल्यूम्स इन माई अदर लेक्चर. सो नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग आप समझिए जो हम नॉर्मल सांस ले रहे हैं और नॉर्मल जो है वो निकाल रहे हैं, जिसमें हम कोई फोर्सफुल एक्टिविटी नहीं कर रहे. सो दैट इज ऑफ ब्रीदिंग. सो इफ दिस मसल गेट डैमेज तो इमीडिएटली ब्रीदिंग सीज हो जाएगी. सेकेंड इज योर इंटरकोस्टल मसल्स. Intercostal muscles. So these muscles, they lie between ribs. So there are two types: external intercostals and internal intercostals. So I refer it as EIC and IIC, right? And this is your phrenic muscles. Now what happened? So coming back to the diagram over here, so these muscles, since they lie between the ribs, that is why we call them as intercostal muscles. So look at this. This is here. यहाँ पे look, ये muscles ऐसे ribs के बीच में हैं. So these muscles are intercostals. So मैं आपके आपको यहाँ पर दो colors में दिखा रही हूँ. So that is my external intercostals. Or here I have used another color. This is my internal intercostals. So two type of muscles are here: external or internal intercostals. Okay, now what happened? First of all, when inspiration take place, what happened in inspiration? Inspiration is said to be an active process. Why? Because it is involving the contraction of the muscles. So what happened over here? First of all, the phrenic or the diaphragm muscle contract. Phrenic muscles contract. जो diaphragm was dome shape to somewhat become flat. It not exactly flat, depending upon हम कितना कर रहे हैं. So it just come down or little bit on flatter side. This is our first thing which happened. Second thing is external intercostal muscles contract. Basically, these are between the ribs. So when they contract like this. 1, 2, 3. So when they will contract on the upper side, pulling the rib cage up front and forward. So इन्होंने क्या किया? Pulled rib cage upward and forward. So that means something like this. If I go by this, look at this over here. So rib cage has been raised like this and your diaphragm is contracted down. If I make it like this, so okay, let me make. This is a side view of the lungs. Something like this. This was in the side view. Now what happened over here? This is your ribs. And here is your diaphragm. Now let's see, this is your diaphragm. Now this diaphragm is contracted. Phrenic muscles which are attaching to the diaphragm, they contract. And this is your rib cage. Like this. And this is again your vertebral column over here. Something like this. Fine. So what happens when diaphragm is, you know, pulled down or it is little becoming flat? It is somewhat here, I should say. Let's see. It comes over here. I'll make with another color. It comes with here, let's see. So you see, this side of the body, we call it as anterior side on the head side. And this is the posterior side. Towards the mouth, this is the ventral side. And over here, towards your back, something like this. This is your dorsal side. So when the rib cage is pulled down, diaphragm is pulled down, the cavity expands anterior posteriorly. That means if the thoracic cavity this expand anterior posteriorly, pulmonary cavity also expanded in the same way, because your outer wall of the, that is your parietal pura, this is very closely invested with the thoracic wall. So what exactly happened? So cavity increases over here. Jo diaphragm hua, to cavity aapki increase kar gayi. Thoracic cavity, or I can say the pulmonary cavity. Thoracic cavity or pulmonary cavity. Because dono same ratio mein chalenge, cavity increases anterior posteriorly. So this has increased anterior posteriorly. Like this, cavity increases anterior posteriorly. And when the external intercostal muscles, they are contracting. See here, they are contracting like this on the upward direction. So when they are contracting like this on the upward direction, so they pull the rib cage outward and see like this. They pull the rib cage outward. So aap ye dekhiye, here is ventral side and this is dorsal side, this is anterior side, this is posterior side. Now your cavity, thoracic cavity, and I should say the pulmonary cavity also in the same way, cavity increases dorsoventrally. So coming by the Boyle's law, hanji, intrapulmonary volumes increase, intrapulmonary pressure decrease. How come? अब किसके relatively बोल रहे हैं? बाहर 760 था, अंदर का volume जो था expand किया, approximately ये और pressure आपका जो था वो आपका decrease हो गया. That comes out to be approximately 579. So there's a difference of the pressure of 1 mm of Hg, यानी कि अंदर का pressure minus 1 mm of Hg आपका आ गया है. तो law क्या कहता है diffusion of gases का? Gas जो है, it moves from high pressure to low pressure. That means air moves inside from atmosphere to lungs. So that means this is a kind of negative pressure generation. सो इंट्रा पल्मोनरी वॉल्यूम आपका डिक्रीज हो गया, सॉरी इंक्रीज हो गया, प्रेशर डिक्रीज हो गया, सो नेगेटिव प्रेशर जनरेशन. तो जो हमारी पहली बात थी कि प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट्स जनरेट होते हैं, सो हेयर इज द नेगेटिव प्रेशर जनरेशन. नाउ वी कम टू द एक्सपिरेशन ओवर हेयर. सो इंस्पिरेशन टू मसल्स आर वर्किंग, फ्रेनिक मसल्स एंड इंटरकोस्टल मसल्स. एग्जैक्टली वॉट हैपन्स इन द एक्सपिरेशन. सो एक्सपिरेशन में क्या हुआ, जो ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट किए थे वो वापस नॉर्मल आ गए. सो आपके फ्रेनिक मसल्स रिलैक्स, डायफ्राम बैक टू नॉर्मल, बैक टू नॉर्मल डोम शेप. डोम शेप्ड एक्सटर्नल इंटरकोस्टल मसल्स, एक्सटर्नल इंटरकोस्टल मसल्स दे ऑल्सो रिलैक्स एंड रिब केज और थोरेसिक केज बैक टू नॉर्मल एंड एयर फ्रॉम इनसाइड मूव्स टू outside. So this is simply recording and that is going. That is why we call it as passive process. But this is only for the, you know, what the normal breathing you are taking or normal breathing you are inhaling. I mean, for the, if you see me, so I'm still at forceful. Normal jo humne kiya aur normal humne nikal diya. If you require any forceful expiration, for example, if I taken that forceful inspiration, so that means my external intercostal muscles are doing more. So that means there's a more contraction of external intercostal muscles. And if I'm expirating hardly, that means I'm putting more force on my another muscles. So for forceful expiration, for forceful expiration, two more muscles are required. That is, number one, abdominal muscles. They contract, and if they contract, they thrust against or push against diaphragm. Push against diaphragm. The lower viscera. What is viscera? The visceral organs, intestine and rest stomach. वो नीचे से उसको pressure दे रहे हैं. Okay? वो contract हो गए तो ऊपर चला गया. Diaphragm. Modo. And second is your internal intercostal. So they also contract. Pulling the rib cage downward and backward. So if you see, आपका diaphragm जो था वो ज्यादा dome हो गया, rib cage जो था वो original position पे आ गया जब expiration हुई. अब क्या हो रहा है कि जिस time पे अगर आपको forceful करना है, so this is your normal. Okay, so back to this diagram again. ये आपका जो नॉर्मल था, फाइन, ओके, लाइक दिस, समथिंग लाइक दिस, एंड हियर इज योर रिब केज एंड नाउ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इंटरनल इंटरकोस्टल मसल्स. Now what they will do, they will pull the rib cage downward like this, and your diaphragm, which is over here, it is becoming more dome. When it is more dome, this is pushing like this. Now see what happened, the pressure over here, So intrapulmonary volume decrease, intrapulmonary pressure increase. बाहर 760 था, अंदर का इंक्रीज हो गया 762, 763, almost this much. So this is again plus 1 से लेकर plus 3 तक की variations चल सकती हैं. And air जो थी वो inside से outside चलेगी. But this is forceful. So this is a kind of forceful, you know, inspiration we have done over here. So in nutshell, now coming back to NCRT wala part. So what we have done over here, see. Inspiration if we see, it involves two type of the muscles. It can occur if inspiration can occur if pressure within the lung, intrapulmonary pressure, is less than the atmospheric pressure. So there's a negative pressure generation over, we have the positive pressure generation. यहाँ पे हमारे पास पॉजिटिव प्रेशर जनरेशन हो चुकी है. विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, सिमिलरली एक्सपिरेशन टेक्स व्हेन इंट्रा पल्मोनरी प्रेशर इज हायर देन एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, द डायफ्राम एंड द स्पेशलाइज्ड सेट ऑफ मसल्स एक्सटर्नल एंड इंटरनल इंटरकोस्टल्स बिटवीन द रिब्स हेल्प्स इन जनरेशन ऑफ सच ग्रेडियंट्स. आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू. And inspiration is initiated by, so NCRT से ये question भी कई बार आ जाता है, the initiation of inspiration is by contraction of your which muscle, phrenic muscles. तो okay, यहाँ पे हम एक ये चीज add भी कर देते हैं. यहाँ पे inspiration is initiated by contraction of diaphragm or phrenic muscles. So it is diaphragm muscles. Fine. Which increases the volume of thoracic chamber in anterior posterior axis, I've already explained to you. This contraction of external intercostal muscles, the contraction of external intercostal muscles lift the rib cage. Lift the rib cage, so causing increase in volume of thoracic chamber in dorsoventral axis. The overall increase in thoracic volume causes similar increase in pulmonary volumes. This I have already discussed in my previous lectures also, and this also, because thoracic wall is very very closely invested with your parietal pleura and which may fit through. So, इसका मतलब जो भी आप अपनी cavity को increase करोगे या decrease करोगे उसी हिसाब से आपके प्रेशर्स चेंज होंगे. यू कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली ऑल्टर दैट वॉल्यूम, सो यू कैन इनडायरेक्टली ऑल्टर दैट वॉल्यूम बाय चेंजिंग द थोरेसिक कैविटी वॉल्यूम्स. एन इंक्रीज इन पल्मोनरी वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज इन इंट्रा पल्मोनरी प्रेशर टू लेस देन दैट ऑफ एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर विच फोर्सेस एयर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड टू मूव इनसाइड द लंग. द लंग्स एक्ट एज अ सक्शन पंप लाइक इन टू this, that is what we call, we are the negative pressure breathers. So we are negative pressure breather. Jo humans hain wo aapke negative pressure breathing hai. Yahi hai ji negative pressure breathing. Because lungs jo hain wo ek suction pump ki tarah kaam karte hain. Okay, fine. So then relaxation of diaphragm and internal costal muscles return the diaphragm and sternum to normal position and reduce the thoracic volume and thereby pulmonary volume. This leads to intrapulmonary pressure to slightly above the atmospheric pressure causing expulsion of air, that is expiration. So that is positive pressure gradient ho gaya aur wo bahar aa gaya. Now very important one more thing, we have ability to increase the strength of inspiration and expiration with the help of additional muscles in abdomen. I have already discussed that. On an average, a healthy human breathe 12 to 16 times a minute. The volume of air involved in breathing movements can be estimated by spirometer, that's an instrument which help in measuring the volumes, which I will discuss in my later lectures in the clinical assessment of pulmonary function. So with sum up karte hue, I will add these two lines more. One is we can increase the strength of breathing, means inspiration and expiration, by an additional set of abdominal muscles. And second was the average your breathing rate hai, that is 12 to 16 times per minute, but this vary. बच्चों में ये थोड़ा ज़्यादा होता है, और अगर हम स्ट्रेसफुल एक्सरसाइज कर रहे हैं, कुछ भी एक्सरसाइज कर रहे हैं, तो ये इंक्रीज हो जाता है टू मीट द इंक्रीज डिमांड ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू वेरी मच, एंड आई होप माय कंटेंट्स आर गोइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू. इफ यू रियली लाइक इट, प्लीज़ लाइक, ऑल्सो शेयर ऑल्सो, एंड सब्सक्राइब, एंड लीव योर फीडबैक विद मी इन माई कमेंट बॉक्स. इफ़ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स, you can always ask me. Thank you.